Welcome back. I'm the Intense MD, a double board certified ICU doctor here to talk about the intensive care unit. On this channel, we talk about the intensive care unit as well as other medical topics. I also have an Instagram page at the Intense MD. Follow me over there for my daily posts as well as some polls, surveys, and interesting facts about me that I share in my stories. I'm currently training for a half marathon, so you can follow my training journey over there. I've been receiving a lot of questions about the COVID Delta variant, so I figured I would do a quick video just giving an overview about what we know so far about the Delta variant, some common questions about this variant, and a little bit of my own experience with the variant and opinions. As always, this video is for educational purposes only. It is not to offer individual medical advice. So first, what is the Delta variant? So they recently changed the naming system in terms of the variants. They initially were using letters and numbers, and now they have changed to Greek letters just to make it easier to differentiate and communicate the variants. The Alpha variant is the variant that was originated in Great Britain. And now the Delta variant is the variant that was first found in India last fall and winter. Based on the epidemiological information that we have gathered so far, they have found that this variant is more contagious compared to the Alpha variant, as well as more severe, leading to more hospitalizations and more deaths. The reason why this is hitting the news lately, considering it was first found in late 2020, is because it is now the dominant strain of the virus in the United States, and there is concern that it may lead to another surge or some hyperlocal mini surges. Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson continue to gather information regarding the vaccine efficacy. I personally received the Pfizer vaccine in December, second dose in January, and have been fully vaccinated for over 6 months. And I am part of the V-Safe program where I will get text messages on a now monthly basis or every other month to follow a link and say if I have had any known exposure to the virus and if I've had any symptoms or have been diagnosed with COVID since receiving the vaccine. So they're still actively gathering information about the vaccines and their efficacy. So far, it has been found that the Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson vaccines are effective against the Delta variant. In terms of natural immunity, which means the person has not received the vaccine, but they had a prior COVID infection, has not shown any efficacy against the virus. So this means if you were previously infected with a different strain of COVID and you did not receive the vaccine, you're still at risk of getting sick from the Delta variant. And as I've said in prior videos, the endpoint for the vaccines was not 0% people getting infected with COVID. It is how many patients died from COVID and how many patients required hospitalization and had severe COVID. There are some cases of people who were previously vaccinated having the Delta variant. Recently, I saw a case in Houston where a wedding that took place in April where every participant was vaccinated and have proof of vaccination. 6 of the 92 attendees to this wedding have come down to COVID and one of them has died. It is important to note that some of these people received vaccine that is not available in the US and has been found to be less effective than the vaccines that we have here, but is still worth noting that there are cases of people who have breakthrough COVID despite being vaccinated. So what am I seeing personally? My healthcare system is a very large healthcare system and we have access to genotyping of the virus. They sent an email that said the Delta variant is now the dominant strain within our healthcare system, which is not a surprise since it is now the dominant strain within the United States. What I have seen in the intensive care unit is last month we had zero COVID patients for a very short period of time, but we had zero COVID patients in our unit for the first time in over a year, which was amazing. And prior to that, the numbers were dwindling. We would have one case, we would have two or three cases. Now it seems that we are having an increase in cases again. Most of these patients have not been vaccinated against COVID. And it is also important to note that there are special populations where the vaccine is not as effective because of their immune system. These patients include people who have received organ transplants because they need to suppress their immune systems after receiving a transplant, people who have autoimmune diseases and need to suppress their immune system for treatment, as well as cancer patients who may be undergoing treatment, or if their cancer, it directly affects their immune system as well. So since these people have abnormal immune systems, they are not able to form the antibodies that a immunocompetent person would be able to form after getting the vaccine. So we are seeing breakthrough cases there as well. So some common questions that I've been receiving is, one, do I still have to wear a mask? There has been a lot of discrepancy between the CDC, public health officials, and experts whether or not people should still be masking. I personally still wear a mask when I'm in public spaces, and that is due to the reasons I listed above, to protect people whose immune systems may not be able to fight off the infection or whose immune systems were not able to form the antibodies against the virus and are still susceptible to the virus. The vaccines are effective against severe COVID and death, but you can still have asymptomatic COVID or mild COVID and transmit it to other people. There's a lot of speculation whether or not there will be another surge. This is my opinion. I personally do not think there will be a massive surge like we had seen in the past year, but I think in areas where there are less percentage of vaccinated people or more susceptible populations, then we will probably see what some experts are referring to as hyperlocal surges, which means we will see surges in little pockets of the country where the vaccination rate is lower. Are there going to be more variants? Probably. In my opinion, yes, there will be. This is how viruses work. If they're not eradicated, they continue to spread, they continue to mutate. So we will see a different variant, whether it'll be more or less contagious, more or less severe than the prior ones. Who knows? It depends on the mutation pattern of the virus. And another question that's been swirling around is, do I need a booster shot if I've been fully vaccinated? And if so, in what time frame? So there are a lot of varying opinions about this. And at this time, the general consensus is no. As I said, these drug companies that made the vaccine are still collecting data about those who have been previously vaccinated, if they're becoming symptomatic, if they have breakthrough infections, and seeing if their immunity has worn off. At this time, there's not enough data to support that a booster shot is needed now, but I suspect we will need to get most likely annual COVID vaccines just like we get annual flu shots. And again, that's my personal opinion. So I'm going to leave some resources below about the Delta variant. I know, as I said, there's a lot of information out there. There's a lot of questions out there. And I just wanted to make a brief video to provide some information about this. I didn't want this to seem like vaccine propaganda. I think at this point, there's enough information out there about the vaccines that everyone can make their informed decision about whether or not they would like to receive it. I think it's important to know the facts in terms of the risk of receiving and not receiving the vaccine, and the risk of not receiving the vaccine at this time appears to be far greater than the risk of receiving it. I hope this provided clarity to some of you who had questions. If you have any further questions, please leave them down below. I will be back on Friday with another video.